Resuming debate, the Honourable Member for Toronto Danforth.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Today I rise to speak about Bill C-346. And for those who have just joined us, Bill C-346 amends the Firearms Act to eliminate the expiration of firearms licenses for those over the age of 18. It essentially makes licenses valid for life, only requiring an update of information every 10 years, with a penalty of a license suspension if the information is not updated. The current legislation requires owners of firearms to renew their license every 5 years. As part of the process, they must update the information relevant to their license eligibility. I'll discuss this in further detail, but at this point, I would like to clearly state that this doesn't seem like an overly onerous requirement to balance against the requirement and responsibility of having a firearms license. I believe everyone in this place can agree. We want to keep firearms out of the hands of people who could be dangerous. Our safety and the safety of our communities is paramount. Canadians and my constituents want to live in a country with effective gun regulations. Millions of Canadians lawfully and responsibly own firearms. Responsible firearms owners understand why it is important for them to be kept out of the wrong hands. As of Sunday, the Toronto Police showed that 324 shootings had occurred in the city of Toronto last year, or this year, including 26 shootings in my community. Canadians understand the importance of doing everything to combat gun crime and keep communities safe. This includes keeping firearms out of the hands of individuals who can be dangerous. But at the heart of this is the fact that whenever we talk about guns, we need to be focusing on responsible gun ownership and the safety of our communities. Our government believes in an effective approach that prioritizes public safety while respecting law-abiding firearms owners. The fundamental principle of the Firearms Act is ensuring public safety. Bill 346 disturbs the balance, and for that reason, I cannot support this bill. Firstly, I cannot support the primary premise of this bill, which appears to be that the current requirements that a firearms owner renew their license every 5 years is too onerous. I talk all the time with my kids about privileges and responsibilities, that when we have certain privileges, we must accept the responsibilities that come along with that privilege. For example, many Canadians have the privilege of driving a car. We accept that this comes with a responsibility to drive the car responsibly and to renew the licenses to ensure that the driver continues to meet eligibility requirements, such as, does the driver still have the eyesight eligibility? Mr. Speaker, you get the idea. Under the current legislation, every 5 years, a responsible firearms owner must renew their license. They update the information relevant to their license eligibility. A renewal notice is sent to licensees about 90 days prior to expiry, and they have a 6-month grace period if the license is, for some reason, not renewed within that timeline. The license renewal forms can be completed online, and the cost is $60 for 5 years. Does this sound too onerous for the responsibility of maintaining and fulfilling your obligations to have the privilege of maintaining lawful firearms ownership? It doesn't to me. What I cannot understand is what is the problem that the member from across the way wants to address. I could understand that we would want to see people update information and to keep their eligibility information current. I cannot accept that we would be promoting responsible firearm ownership or keeping our communities safe by taking away the renewal every 5 years. We can all logically understand the principle behind license renewals. Circumstances change, and we can all understand that an individual might qualify for a firearms license at one point and in the future not meet those qualifications. Under the current regime, the information collected every 5 years is critical to protecting the public. It is an invaluable tool for the chief firearms officers who review the information to determine whether there are safety risks associated with allowing an individual continued lawful access to firearms. One of the most key parts of the current 5-year license information update is what information can be investigated under Section 55 of the Firearms Act to determine whether an applicant is eligible to hold a license. 55 states a chief firearms officer or the registrar may require an applicant for a license or authorization to submit such information. In addition to that, included in the application, as may be reasonably regarded as relevant for the purposes of determining whether an applicant is eligible to hold the license or authorization. Without restricting the scope of the inquiries that may be made with respect to an application for a license, a chief firearms officer may conduct an investigation of the applicant, which may consist of interviews with neighbors, community workers, social workers, individuals who work or live with the applicant, spouse or common law partner, former spouse or former common law partner, dependents, or whomever in the opinion of the chief firearms officer may provide information pertaining to whether the applicant is eligible under Section 5 to hold the license. So, a firearm license holder's personal situation, including mental health, employment, and marital status, can change numerous times in a 10-year period. By moving a requirement to update the chief firearms officer every 10 years, it will make it more difficult to determine all the factors in a person's changing life. I also would like to address a specific part of the renewal eligibility requirements that should be emphasized and should be viewed through a gender-based analysis. One aspect of the license renewal eligibility concerns the owner's role in domestic violence. The key part of the 5-year license information update is that the current or former partners of an individual may be contacted about their concerns regarding extending the privilege of that person to acquire a firearm and to continue with their license. In a 2011 Statistics Canada report on family violence in Canada, they found that from 2001 to 2009, in 53% of spousal murder suicides, the cause of death was shooting. According to the RCMP 2015 Commissioner of Firearms report, in 2015, almost 400,000 new or renewal of individual licenses were issued, and 688 applications were refused. Of these refusals, 40 were because of domestic violence. I am proud that our government has adopted Canada's first gender-based violence strategy. Taking that into account and the fact that women who leave an abusive spouse are at particular risk of violence, it seems reasonable to me that we have a system that allows for this factor to be reviewed every 5 years. I should add that domestic violence can be the basis for a license to be revoked if an issue arises before the 5-year renewal. But every 5 years, we have a chance to review. In addition, 112 of the refusals were because of mental health, 203 refusals were because there was a concern that a person would be a danger to themselves, and 132 refusals were because there was a concern that a person would be a danger to others. The refusals are just a handful of the new and renewal licenses issued, as we would hope and we would expect. Can't we all agree that it is better for us to remove the privilege that comes with a firearms license from a person who is involved in domestic violence, is viewed as a threat to themselves, or is viewed as a danger to others? Isn't that at the heart of public safety? And this isn't just a question of renewing a license every 5 years or every 10, because under this proposed legislation, if the license is not updated at the 10-year timeline, it does not expire. It is not a 10-year license that expires. At 10 years, the license is suspended. My colleague, the Parliamentary Secretary for the Minister of Public Safety, laid out very clearly all of the unanswered questions of Bill C-346 in respect to suspension. It's not a defined term in the legislation that we have. What does a license suspension mean? Would people who have suspended licenses be allowed to continue possessing firearms? Would they be allowed to purchase ammunition? Would they be allowed to buy or sell or trade firearms? Can the suspended license be confiscated? All this ambiguity in the Firearms Act is unacceptable, and it clearly does not prioritize public safety. I understand that when we talk about all of these matters in the House, that there are different perspectives. I've heard them. And I am not a gun owner. I represent a community of fewer gun owners than many of my colleagues. I understand that. In my community, there are incidents of shootings that make our community feel unsafe. 2 weeks ago, a man was shot a couple blocks from my house with a child in a vehicle. I spoke to constituents recently who have bullet holes and broken windows from a shooting at the beginning of this summer. Our government will be implementing measures consistent with our platform and ensure that criminals and individuals who pose a danger to themselves or the public are not able to obtain and use firearms. I will not be supporting this bill, Mr. Speaker. To me, it is not a heavy burden for gun owners to actually renew their licenses on the 5 years as the current legislation requires. Thank you.